Welcome back to the Straight with End, everyone. How are you guys doing? I am back. We are back. And of course, I want to bring you the latest news. I do have to say, I took a couple days break. It needed to just reset the batteries after the season that we had. But as I said, we are back. And as you see in the thumbnail, Frenkie De Jong, a price has been set, shall I say? And a potential deal for Darwin Nunez is on the cards. But as I always say, subscribe to the channel, please. Our goal is 1,000 subscribers before the end of the year. And of course, links to our various socials in the description. But guys, how are you doing, really? A lot of news has come through. A lot of things being spoken about surrounding Manchester United. We've seen the unveiling. We've seen the glorious moments of Ten Hag walking around Old Trafford, greeting every staff member and every particular fan that he might have come across in and around Manchester. It's fantastic and awesome to see. Gives you warm feelings. It gives you a sense of, shall I say, home. Ten Hag said it himself in his interview with the press conference. This is his home. And he seemed to fit in quite seamlessly. But let me get to the real reason why you are here. And let's get into the news without further ado. So, on Darwin Nunez, it has been reported by The Men, which is the Manchester Evening News. It has said that Jorge Mendes, the agent of both Ronaldo and Bruno Fernandes, is working on a deal for Darwin Nunez. Manchester United have been in talks over a move. Well, that sounds positive. I've said we do need an out-and-out number 9. I've, on plenty occasions, mentioned Darwin Nunez, said how important he would be to Ten Hag's system and to Manchester United. And to hear that Jorge Mendes, a well-known agent in the world, you know, just as big as Emilio Raiola, you know, perhaps he can strike a deal for Manchester United. We are in talks with him. Darwin Nunez has said that he's leaving Benfica. He has said that he wants a Premier League move. But you have to look at it and be realistic. Can we offer him what other clubs can offer him? Chelsea, Liverpool, they can offer him Champions League. Is that what might turn his head? Maybe, maybe not. We have to see. But you also have to look at the possibility that Jorge Mendes is the agent involved. And he will have connections to Manchester United as Bruno and Ronaldo have shown. But he can be speaking to Ronaldo. Ronaldo could be speaking to Nunez. It's all a good possibility. There is a chance for us to get Darwin Nunez, but we have to be realistic. What if we don't get him? And if we don't get him, who do we go for then? You guys can let me know in the comments who you think might be a striker that you would want to see at Manchester United for Ten Hag next season. Obviously, bar Ronaldo. But there are other options, but Darwin Nunez is the number one target up front for us. And if we want him, we have serious competition. There's talks of Roberto Firmino leaving Liverpool. That leaves a spot open for Darwin Nunez. Chelsea have Lukaku, Havertz and Werner, but we know that he could potentially be a better striker for them. So even though we want him, even though Jorge Mendes is there, there is competition. We have to be realistic. But Darwin Nunez, definitely there is talks over a deal for him to come to Manchester United. Let me move on to Frenkie de Jong. We've seen plenty of news surrounding Frenkie de Jong and exactly where his future might be next season. Barcelona have said that they have a financial issue. Xavi has said that he would like to keep him. Barcelona's president have said that they would like to keep him. However, the financial issues definitely has a role to play. And this is what has been reported by Rob Dawson. And it says, Frenkie de Jong's transfer fee is reportedly in the region of 75 million euros. Manchester United are unlikely to agree those terms. However, with Barcelona's situation, they might have to compromise when it comes to transfer fees. So, as I've said plenty of times, Frenkie de Jong to Manchester United is on. Manchester City have said that they are not interested in Frenkie de Jong and are more likely to sign Calvin Phillips from Leeds United as a replacement for Fernandinho. No other clubs in the Premier League want him. He would want a Premier League move. Ten Hag is our manager. So Frenkie de Jong is a potential transfer. He is the midfield target that we have. We lost Tchouaméni to Real Madrid. Kind of, we were not even in the race for him. So that was expected. But a player like Frenkie de Jong can definitely come in and, shall I say, fill Pogba's shoes? No. But be better than him at the club and for Ten Hag and our midfield. So Frenkie de Jong is definitely on, and it's something that we have to keep our eyes out for. Because with Darwin Nunez there, with Frenkie de Jong being known, and of course, Jurrien Timber being one step away from joining Manchester United, verbal terms have been agreed, and we are in talks with Ajax, and we are not far from finalizing a deal for Jurrien Timber. So potentially three good signings. Jurrien Timber at centre-back, Frenkie de Jong, and Darwin Nunez. We know for a fact Ten Hag has started work already. He's been at work way before he was even officially unveiled as the Manchester United manager. So transfers are going to come through quick and fast. News will come through quick and fast. We'll be linked to a lot of players, but there will be the concrete ones, such as the Nunez, the Timbers, and the Frenkie de Jongs. And I'll bring that to you here on the Stratford Inn. Let me know what you think about the Frenkie de Jong transfer story and what you think might be its conclusion. I want to now speak to you about Ten Hag's part two for the interview that he had, his first official interview at Manchester United. And speaking on playing against Premier League sides, he said, useful, yes, definitely, because we have to get the way of playing. We have to present our way of playing. With our way, I mean Manchester United's way. He also spoke about a potential game against Manchester City and Liverpool in the league. And he said, yes, of course. They are exciting games because you get the challenge to play against the best managers by the best players. I'm really looking forward to it. But I think every game is a challenge. Now, this is good to hear. And it's good to hear that he's excited to test himself against the likes of Klopp and Guardiola and their players. And that shows that he has a standard that he wants to set at Manchester United. That's the bar that he wants to reach and potentially raise. So good to hear, good confidence speaking from our manager, and it definitely gives us as fans confidence in his vision, in his plan for Manchester United. I want to just give you a quick update on our pre-season and what exactly it entails, who will be playing and where. And let me get into it. And it says, we will be starting our pre-season against Liverpool on the 12th of July in Thailand's capital at the Rajamangala Stadium. And after that, we will then fly to Australia and we will then visit Melbourne and play Melbourne Victory on the 15th of July. Then, also in Melbourne, we'll play against Crystal Palace, the team that won us 1-0 in the final game of the season. We'll play them in a friendly on the 19th of July. And to round that off in Australia, in Perth, we'll be playing Aston Villa on the 23rd of July. So, a good preseason, Premier League teams only, and that shows a sense of Ten Hag wanting to test himself and test his players against other Premier League players. He wants to have a running start to our season by having a very good preseason. And that being said, I want to now speak to you on exactly that. And this is what is interesting for this preseason. Ten Hag has started his work early, terminated his contract with Ajax early, came into Manchester, started doing work, started phoning, making calls, speaking to players, getting things in place, preparing the team, preparing the staff, and preparing the work for the preseason. And it has even gone further into this particular report. And it says, Ten Hag's demand for control has stretched to Ten Hag demanding to know where his Manchester United players are going on holiday this summer. Some players believe that it is a test to which of them are committed to being in the best possible shape when they return for pre-season. Ten Hag is also said to want to know all about his players, families and home life, so we can make a full assessment of their character and how they lead their lives. Now, isn't that brilliant news? Think about it, guys. Think about it. He wants to know everything exactly to do with the player. His family life, home life, how he presents himself, how he lives his life. He wants to ensure that they come back and know exactly where they are on holiday, to keep track of them, to see if they are actually working on themselves, doing personal fitness training sessions, working with the ball, improving themselves as a player, to come back strong, to start the preseason strong, so that they can work hard in preseason to have a good start to the season. That's brilliant. That is good to see and hear that Ten Hag is expecting this of his players, that there are some players already committing to that and have already shown respect to the coach. I've seen on the likes of TikTok, Anthony Elanga showing that he is doing his preseason work already now. He hasn't stopped working. And that is what Ten Hag is expecting. He wants his players to be tip-top shape. They need to be super fit in order to play in his system, in order to go and compete. And that is what we need. That is what we need at the club. The culture needs to change to that particular hard-working, winning mentality. That elite mentality that Klopp and Guardiola and Tuchel, etc. have driven at their respective clubs. We now have a manager who has that exact mindset and wants to take Manchester United back to the top. Guys, I am excited. It's literally giving me butterflies at what is coming for the next season. But definitely, you'll be here to join us on the Stretford Inn. Guys, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Our goal is 1,000 subscribers before the end of the year. And thank you to those who have watched the video thus far, and for those who have actually taken the time to watch the video to the end. Have a wonderful day further. Till we speak again soon, Red Devils. Bye-bye.